So the piano that I spend my life on has 88 keys, every octave in 12 parts. And so that's the challenge and interest to seeing how you can create gestures and sonorities with this instrument that are kind of amazing.
Yeah, they show me this box with this 435 key beast in it. And I mean, my first thought was like, you know, this really should be in a museum. So this project kind of blurs the gap as to whether or not it's the original object or it's kind of a recreation of the original object or a facsimile, a playable facsimile of a keyboard called the Moog Rothenberg keyboard. Of course, Moog refers to Robert Moog, who is one of the inventors of the synthesizer. And David Rothenberg was a math professor, largely involved with early AI missile trajectory. And his big thing was pattern recognition. And if you go by his abstracts, and what he was trying to do was to create this machine that could, in theory, interpret the pitches in between pitches. So Rothenberg commissions Robert Moog, who at that time, this is before really the founding of Moog music. You know, it's before there's the giant wall size or room size instruments that, you know, would be used by the Beatles or the Rolling Stones or anything kind of going on from there. So anyway, Moog takes his time on this and ends up not delivering. They have a one octave mock-up of this, which is pretty amazing that they were able to do that with 1960s era World War II surplus technology. You know, only at Cornell would I have an opportunity to really work on this kind of historical instrument. But how can I also do it in such a way where there's respect to the instrument, where I'm not actually, you know, taking apart the original circuitry? You know, I would hate to unsolder something that was soldered, you know, 50 years ago by Robert Moog. We have 60 years of additional technology at our disposal, 60 years of mistakes from technologists and musicians and builders that we can kind of pull from to create something that at least will approximate what it is that they tried to do in the beginning.
Are you going to be the first person to perform this?
I guess I will be the first person to attempt to perform it, yes. Elizabeth Ogonek and I have put together a session where everyone will collaborate. We have, I think, six of us total, perhaps seven. It'll be like a microtonal jam band.
The first thought that goes through my mind is like, this is so amazing. I can't believe Travis has managed to actually make this work. It's so cool to look at. It's so cool to hear. I have no idea actually how to essentially write for this instrument, but I'm going to have a lot of fun finding out.
We'll rehearse, we'll record, and then October 24th, we'll play what we've come up with in Barnes Hall as a concert.
We need some bells.
Oh, bells.
Thank you.
I can only hope that after it's played in the concert with Zach, that other people will take up the charge and that it leads to an interest both in the history and the story, and also, I guess, just in this kind of like strange, unique instrument that, like, you know, people would like to play and experiment with.
Thank you.